Hey guys, Sponge Murphy here. So tonight I'm going to be looking at the new Dark Eldar release from Games Workshop. I think I'm going to do this more like a regular thing. We're just going to have a look at some of the new releases that they have and share my opinion on them. So the new release that they have now is the Dark Eldar stuff. I'm not going to ramble too much on about it because 40k isn't really my specialty, and especially Dark Eldar, I really know very little about him. But the first one you have here is this guy called, hopefully I can pronounce this right, Himangculus. So I'm sure it's something like that, and I'm pretty sure I'm butchering how to pronounce it. But this is like a brand new figure they had, and if you can't figure out how to pronounce the name, this model makes up for it 10 times over. It's absolutely beautiful. It's really nice looking. They've really outdone themselves this time, this one. If I remember right, I think I have a picture of the old one that was out before this guy. So just have a quick look here. Oh no, it's Orion Rackhart is the guy I'm thinking of. I thought it was just a new model for him, but it's not. So just having a quick look at it. Now, if I'm missing something completely obvious with Dark Eldar, please let me know. He has like this tentacle coming up along his back. It's like a stitch to his back and it's coming down. That's what's keeping him up in the air, that kind of big tentacle thing. Goes up to his back and up around to the top with like a spike on it. Where's it going a little bit? There you go. I don't like the colours they chose for his, I think you'd call it robe maybe. Simply because the one I have here, the Orion Rackhart one, I'm pretty sure I'll find it. Oh no, he has kind of like an apron thing there at the front, but it's all like skin, and it's all like stitched together skin. So if I got this guy, I'd pretty much do that with all that. Get it look like it's all skin stitched together. Because these guys, from what I remember, is they're really evil. Like, they torture people and everything, like, big time. Like, space pirates, that type of thing. This guy's pretty skinny. Look, I like his feet at the bottom. Like, it really shows that he's been elevated upwards. You know, and he has a stitch on the head, which is pretty cool up there. So he must be some type of, I don't want to say a doctor, but like a scientist kind of Eldar guy, because he has like a syringe type of thing there, and you can see just kind of behind it looks like some other medical equipment that he has kind of in under the ropes. There you can see some like blades that they kind of look like for surgical equipment that scientists or maybe doctors would use. He has some Eldar gun, I don't know what that's called. And then he has all these pump things on his back. And I'm sure they're for like giving him power or keeping him going or whatever. I really don't know much about the Dark Eldar. But this guy's pretty awesome. Maybe someday, if I haven't got much stuff left to paint, which will probably be never, I might pick this guy up. He's pretty cool. I really like the paint him. I'd really like to get my hands on him. I think he's, how much is he, 20 euro. So, let's have a look at this one. We can have a look at close-ups. You can see the stitching on his head there more clearly. And you can see more of the green vein coming from his neck into kind of his chest and shoulder. And he has like these hooks just like above his nipples as well. I didn't even notice that. And you can see these pump things as well, pumping that fluid around his body or something like that. And the big lump of flesh there that's up around that tentacle as well. These guys run into a lot of weird shit, I'd imagine. And there's, you can see the syringe thing a bit more clearly there. And there's like his claw finger. This is the best way to describe it. And it's all in one sprue as well, which is pretty cool. I suppose, yeah, a little bit of a shocker that he's all on one sprue, but I'd imagine he's a lot smaller than you think. So yeah, so that's it for Homunculus, or however you pronounce it, just a little bit of fluff here. A deranged flesh sculptor that dwell in dank bowels of Comarca. These master torturers expect. Yeah, there you are. That's the type of thing I was thinking they were into. I'd imagine they're like the lab guys of a bad group that would like kidnap and do like experiments and stuff. So I'm moving on to him. Oh yeah, this guy is already out now. He was like off for pre-order last week sometime, so this guy is available now. And the Racks, these guys look, I think these guys look awesome, but when I heard that no one ever uses them because they're not meant to be that good in the game, it's kind of a pity. I'm gonna move over this way. I'll zoom in a bit so we get a better look. I don't know, they kind of remind me of these like Spartan or Gladiator type guys with the helmet. You know, they kind of have like, where they just have the armor around their waist and the kind of, I don't know what you'd call it, like robe things. The waist are pretty skinny. They have some. Oh, look at that guy, he has like a head, like the pump thing coming up on the head in it. It's pretty sick. And these guys have the same things as well. Look at the surgical equipment, so I'd imagine they're the same type of guys as the last. As Homunculus, whatever. However you pronounce it, I'm just giving up on it now. I wonder if I can move this over. This guy. Yeah, they all have the pump things going into their bodies as well. I have a box of these. They were the fine cast ones. I wonder if we can get a 360 look on this guy. I have a box of the old ones of these. I'm pretty sure the racks, I must take them out. The fine cast ones. But I think these guys can be changed, and I'll have a look at it after this. They're like a multi-part thing. And the fine cast ones weren't, I don't think. So I was gonna like, give them away for a competition, but they're kind of starting to grow on me a little bit. And why is this getting stuck on 94%? I'll try it again. Oh, he won't stay like that. It's all good in the hood. Yeah, there's a close up with the guy with the head. I don't know what he's attached to. Maybe it's like another tentacle claw thing coming out of his back. Same with this guy, it's over his head as well. Yeah, and there are just the other three guys in the unit. These are the guys that I like. I should go over that way. Keep it on that. The red kind of fleshy colour on these are the ones that I wish the fine cast ones I had turned into. These guys look pretty awesome. I like the flesh colours. Although, I wonder, let me check this guy. Yeah, no, they don't. I think them bodies are the exact same. This guy has two arms. I don't see the guy. So I don't know if you can make like two different units, and I think them bodies are the same. It's just the kind of the, I don't know, like the body effects, the lines you can see a lot more clearly with the red color. So this guy has two big meat hooks as well. Look at that. That's pretty cool. That is actually pretty cool. I like to have that. Yeah, and you don't see any features with the mask on. Like, you don't see, I assume they're completely faceless. Like, they don't give nothing away. These guys are, I'd imagine, like, nothing could do no emotion or anything. And this is a rack driving one of the orcs, one of their ships. I don't know if they can do that. It kind of looks pretty cool. Little pilot guy. So let's just have a look at the fluff thing down the bottom. To say this 86p, how much is this? 29 euro. This 86 piece plastic kit makes 5 racks. Each rack can be equipped with hooked blades and all that stuff. This kit also 2 additional set of arms to also gives you the extra arms if you want to make a raider pilot or a gunner for the Hulk. That's pretty cool. As attendants and servants to the Hemanculi. Oh, so these guys are servants for the first guy. Yeah, master surgical surgical craftsmanship and individual cut apart. Yeah, so I'd imagine these guys kind of do the heavy work for them. So if you're into your kind of torturing guys, let's have a look at the box. It's pretty cool. Oh, you have the guy with the head on the side of it. Yeah, these are the guys to go for if you're wanting like a really dark type of guys. The fluff of these is pretty dark. Another called Dark Elder. And that one's not loading up. But you know, you don't see getting the torturing guys or something, doing surgical things. I think I might just start looking at the more fluff of them. I'm not mad on a lot of the Dark Elder models, but the fluff looks pretty cool. So, and the last two then, this is the stuff that's up for pre-order right now as of, I think you'll be able to get it like this Saturday. Now this is the Codex, and this is like the ones that they bring out. This is the one where it's only like 1,000 made worldwide. Yeah, and it's €145. And I was looking at this and I was like, really? €145 for books? I know you get your Codex and everything. But the stuff in it, like what is in it? I was looking at it the other day. And I was trying to justify how does it add up to like that much money. Get a Dark Eldar Dracon edition, which is a true collector's piece, blah 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 blah. The Wipe Store exclusive Codex. Yeah, you get, there's only 1,000 of these. So you get the new Codex. And the Dark Eldar Painting Guide. And Raiders of Camarac. I think that's what the painting guide is called. Both books represent in a sleek slipcase interior. Yeah, so you get like a fancy case and everything. And you get so you get the data sheets. And you get objective markers and let's just have a quick look at them. So it's all in one nice little slip and you get the number thing on the top of it. I'll zoom in here. At the top of it, you'll get like, if you got number 100, it'll be like number 100 up on that. And there's the cover, the one in the books, which is pretty nice. Then just like a Dark Elder symbol for, I don't know what clan it is. Just another cover. And there's the data. Yorks, I think you get. And objective markers. So, if anyone does know about this, I would like to know, like, is this kind of worth the €145? I'm pretty much a fantasy collector, and if they brought out like a Skaven army book and it was all this stuff with it for like €145, I still wouldn't get it. And not that I wouldn't recommend it, but it's just simply I don't know and I've never seen it, like, so I'm sure the quality is like brilliant. I know people are saying about the Nagash book, like it's the quality is like brilliant. But yeah, there you go. If I spend €145 on a book, there you go, that's your one. And finally, Five Draven Bomber. Now I'm not mad on Dark Eldar ships, I don't know why and I can't figure out why. Not that there's anything wrong with them, but they're just not my cup of tea. Now they're really nice and I don't know. I can't seem to just like say, oh wow, I really love one of them. Let's see if we can get a 360 view on this one. Hopefully this one should load up. Oh actually I missed to see how much the price was. I'm not going back in it now. Yeah, there we go. Actually that makes it look a hell of a lot nicer than I thought. It does look pretty. I Actually, look at the bass. Is that backwards on the bass? I wonder if I turn it. Like, should the ship not be facing that way? Like that, should we at the back of the bass point that way? That's just what I would have thought. Yeah, the good thing about these ships, though, they do give you a lot of space if you want to do freehand. I know Claydog does a lot of really good LR ships. Yeah, it looks pretty nice from here. I like the bomb underneath it there. I'll zoom in a bit more. That bomb underneath there is pretty cool. You know, it is designed pretty nicely. It does look a lot nicer in the 360 view. Yeah, I think in that one there, it looks like the base is... No, that base doesn't even look horrible. But enough about the base. There's your guns and everything for it. That's that. Sure, I'm pretty sure it's like a cannon type of thing. Shuriken cannon, maybe, I don't know. Maybe that's normal leather. It's a different weapon you can have on it. And that's underneath it. What's that? I think that's the... Is that the bottom of it underneath it? Or maybe that's the top of it. I can't tell. There's a sprue. Pretty nice looking sprue. Oh, and that's your... For the cockpit. So, yeah, the last one is the Void... What's it called? Void Raven Bomber. Let's have a look at the fluff on this. 71 piece kit. Heavy support, the Dark Eldar Forces. Yeah, so it's your heavy support one. I imagine there's a lot of big weapons on it, a lot of missiles. So, pretty nice little centerpiece you can have for your Dark Eldar armor. I think it's. I think if I just had to look on that, like from there. I think it's okay looking, like I'm not mad on that. But once you get that 360 look, it's pretty cool. I like it when it's like it shows how high up it can be and everything. You know? And you can go mental with the base, I can put like stuff up on it because it goes pretty high. So that one's €62. Man, that's not cheap. It must be a lot bigger than the other ones. Because there's the Razorwing Jet Fighter. And that's only 36, so it's like nearly twice as much as that. So, yeah, that's my thoughts on the Dark Eldar stuff. I've been rambling on a bit too long about pretty much nothing that I know about it. But, let me know what you guys think about it. Let me know if you'd like to see me keep doing this with the new releases. You know, it's certainly going to try and keep it up anyway. So, let me know what your thoughts are about the new releases, the new Dark Elder ones. Especially this guy. This guy's pretty cool. I think this guy's my favourite of all of them. Yeah, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. I'm looking forward to hearing from yous. And I'll see you guys in the next video then. And from this guy, see you later.